I'm Erica Lusky, and I'm from Michigan in the United States. I was taking some notes, not in a linear fashion, but just sort of all over, and I was visualizing when she was talking. And my notes really are a reflection of many of the presenters and speakers that I've heard over the day today. And I do this type of recording not only for myself, but I think it's important to share for others that weren't here today. So I will probably post these on social media in some way. My learning for today, as I continue to experience it, it helps me to summarize these ideas. Because it's sort of telling a story. And actually, Natalie, I felt was really a storyteller today, an inspiring, congenial storyteller on what it means to be a teacher for her students. And these notes also are my story of learning. And I think that was a common theme between her presentation and those of us that are taking notes, perhaps. And we're just trying to capture the story that we had today. I think by allowing abstract ideas, you can metaphorically look at language and the world, and I feel like that just opens up a huge door for learning and understanding. I need to do this to process better because the pictures really help me. So the words alone won't stand out for me later, but like this knot, for example, that was used as an example of allowing students to just talk and listen to them, I will remember that knot forever and the metaphor that was given along with it. So I'm color coding by presenter and sometimes by ideas. And then later on, I might even draw lines to form connections between people and their ideas. So two reasons that I think it's important to project these ideas for others. First of all, not everybody could have this amazing opportunity and be here at ICOT in Miami. And so by sharing that with others, they can take what they want from it. Yeah. And also, the second reason is, while these are just my ideas, there might be even just like one little idea that someone has connected to someone else's, and someone else's and someone else's, and we're all just grabbing ideas from each other, even one little piece at a time. I think that offering several modalities for learning visually by making, I think just offering those opportunities for someone, if you'd like to write in black and white and take linear notes, then great. If you like to think in pictures, then that's great too. If you like to make and do things with your hands, those opportunities should be open.
Yeah. Thank you.
Does that help?